So we have given the definition of sequential circuits just now itself. So the output depends on the applied input variables and the past output. In order to store the past output, we require a storage element. So that storage elements are nothing but latches and flip-flops. So latch is a storage element. Right? It stores a single bit of information, one bit of information, either a 0 or 1, right? So it is a storage element, it stores a single bit of information, either a 0 or 1. So in order to store this information, we have to apply inputs to this, and there is no clock pulse. This is the example of asynchronous circuits. Latch is an example of asynchronous sequential logic circuit. Let us see what are the latches we have. First one, SR NOR latch. This is active high. The meaning is 0 represents 0 volts, 1 represents 5 volts. S stands for set reset. S is nothing but set. R is nothing but reset. As there are two states in binary language, that is 0 and 1, set represents 1, reset represents 0. So the name given as SR NOR latch, and this latch is designed using NOR gates. See, I will take NOR gate. This is NOR gate, right? We will take two NOR gates. Based on the definition of sequential logic circuit, the output of the circuit depends on the applied inputs as well as the past outputs. So in any sequential logic circuit, there are two outputs. One is true output and second one is complemented output. Right? So this is a sequential logic circuit. Let us see. This is memory element. Q and Q bar. Right? True output and complemented output. This is combinational logic circuit. So there are two outputs in sequential logic circuits. They are, one is true output, second one is complemented output. This is Q, this is S, this is R. I am connecting these input from this output. This feedback acts as storage here. This feedback elements acts as storage. So this is the logic circuit of SR latch. Q bar. True output, complemented output. Right? Logic circuit of SR NOR latch. So if you take truth table of this circuit, so how many inputs are available? 1, 2, and also this output is also called as next state Qn plus 1, and it has past output, it has present state, right? Input variables and the present state and the next state. So there are three input variables here. One is S R Qn, this is Qn, present state. Next state Qn plus 1. As there are 3 inputs, there will be 8 combinations. 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 1 1 1 double 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1. So this is a circuit of SR NOR latch. It is very easy to design. That is, it is designed using NOR gates. So as I have explained you, the sequential logic circuit, in sequential logic circuits, the output of the circuit depends on the present input variables as well as the past outputs. So this feedback acts as a storage element. In this case, we have seen in terms of block diagram, but this is representation in terms of circuit. So this feedback acts as a storage part, right? By using two NOR gates, see, one of the input is connected to input variable, one of the input of this gate is connected to input variable, and the other inputs of these two gates are connected as feedback from the output, right? These two inputs are getting from the outputs. We have two outputs in case of sequential logic circuit. One is true output, complemented output, right? And also, if you look at the truth table, while preparing the truth table, as there are two inputs, we don't know the past output. We have to consider the past output, that is present state, as input. So if you consider the present state as input, there are three combinations. By using these three combinations, by using these three inputs, there will be 8 combinations. They are 0 0 0 0 0 1 0 1 0 0 double 1 1 double 0 1 0 1 1 1 0 1 1 1, right? Here, as we don't know the past output, we have to assume in binary we have only two values, either 0 or 1. So we have to assume the past output, that is present state, by the first time as 0, by the second time as 1, for same combination of inputs, present variables, right? So S is 0, R is 0, S is 0, R is 0, only past output is changing. Here both are same, only past output is changing, both are same, past output is changing, both are same, past output is changing, right? So as there are two NOR gates, I will designate these gates as gate 1, gate 2. It is not mandatory to give the inputs, as you can also interchange, like you can give S here, R here, right? If you know the function of NOR gate, you can easily get the next states of this, right? In order to switch the state from present state to next state, what are the required inputs? We have to define the next states here. We have to derive the next states by using these inputs. So let us see. You know, in NOR gate there are two inputs, right? The logic expression of NOR gate is A plus B whole complement. So when A is 0, B is 0, the output will be 1. For the remaining cases, the output will be 0. The output of NOR gate is the complement of OR gate. In OR gate, these three will be 1s in the output. The complement of this will be this one. When you apply both inputs are 0, 0, the output will be 1. So we know the function of NOR gate, right? And I have applied the input terminals S here, R here, and this is a simple SR NOR latch. The block diagram representation of this is this one. It has two inputs, S, R, and two outputs, Q, Q complement, SR, NOR, latch. This is true output complemented output. This is block diagram representation. This is circuit representation. These are inputs. Right? Now let us see carefully. If you concentrate for 5 minutes, you can easily derive, you can easily define the other SR NAND latch, and also you can easily understand the flip-flops concept, right? Most of the people will feel this is difficult, but in my point of view, it is very easy when you compare with the combinational logic circuits. Sequential circuits are very easy to understand when you compare with combinational logic circuits. Just you have to concentrate. Now I am applying the inputs from the truth table in order to get the next states by depending on the values of present state. See, first combination I am taking, S is 0, R is 0. I will apply S is 0 here, R is 0 here. The past output we don't know. By the first time we are assuming the past output as 0. If you assume the past output as 0, this is true output. This is connected to true output, and we have a complemented output here. If true output is 0, that is past output is 0, the complement of this will be 1. So 0 is appearing here, right, as it is connected in feedback form to the input of NOR gate 2, one of the input of NOR gate 2. The other input of NOR gate is 0, 0, 0. What is the output you have here? 1. The output of NOR gate is 1. Yes, we have 1 here. Now 1 appears here. This 1 appears here. 0, 1 are the inputs to NOR gate 1. For these inputs, what is the output of NOR gate? 0. If the present state is 0, right? When inputs are 0, 0, if the present state is 0, the output obtained is 0. I will write 0 as it is here. Next, I will change the present state. I will put the same inputs, S is 0, R is 0. I am assuming the present state is 1. The present state is 1. So 1 appears here. The complement of this will be 0. 0, 1 are the inputs to NOR gate 2. What is the output you have? 0. So 1 complement form is 0. This is true. This 0 appears here. 0, 0 are the inputs to NOR gate 1. 0, 0 are the inputs to NOR gate 1. What is the output you have? 1. So when you apply inputs S is 0, R is 0, if you assume the past output as 1, what is the next state you have obtained? 1. Right? The meaning of this is, if you want to store a value, already let us assume you have stored some value in the latch, either 0 or 1. If you want to retain the value as it is, right, you have to apply this combination, because when you apply S is 0, R is 0, if the past output stored is 0, if you want to retain the value as it is, you have to give this combination, because the next state you are getting is same as past output. This is the next state, same as past output, that is present state. Right? If let us assume 1 is stored in the latch, because latch is a storage element, it stores a single bit of information. Let us assume you have stored already a 1 value in that. If you want to retain the 1 value as it is, you have to apply this combination so that the 1 is retained as it is. When you apply S is 0, R is 0, if the past output is 1, the next state is 1. Next state you are getting same as past output. See, this is 0, 1, this is 0, 1. So you can call this as no change state. Right? No change. The next state is not going to be changed. Whatever the past output you have, you are getting the same past output as next state. Now let us see the second condition. I am applying 0, 1 here. S is 0, R is 1. I am assuming the past output as 0. The complement of this will be 1. Right? This 0 appears here. 0, 0 will be 1. And 1 appears here. 1, 1 will be 1, 1 will be 0. The next state you have obtained is 0. Right? Simply I will write this 0 here. Next, I will assume the past output as 1 by applying the same inputs. So 1 is appearing here, the complement of this will be 0. So when you apply 0, 1 inputs to the NOR gate, the output is 0. This 0 comes here. When you apply 0, 1 inputs to the NOR gate, you are getting 0 here. Right? 0. I will place this 0 here. So when you apply S is 0, R is 1, if you assume the past output as 0, the next state is 0. When S is 0, R is 1, if you assume the past output as 1, the next state is 0. Nothing but for the combinations of S is 0, R is 1, whatever may be the past output, a 0 value is stored in the latch. If you want to store a 0 value in the latch, you have to apply any of these combinations from these two. So we call this as reset state. Right? Reset. We call that condition as reset. Reset is nothing but 0. A 0 value is stored in the latch. Next. I am taking S is 1, R is 0. See, S value is 1, R value is 0, the past output is 0, right? The complement of this is 1, 0, 1, if you apply inputs to the NOR gate, the output is 0, this 0 is appearing here. If you apply 0, 0, inputs to the NOR gate, the output will be 1, 1, 0, right? So if you apply this input combination, S is 1, R is 0, past output is 0, the next state of the latch is 1, the value 1 is stored. If you assume the past output as 1, right, for the same combination of S and R, the complement of this is 0, so 1 is appearing here. When both inputs of NOR gate are 1, 1, the output is 0. This 0 appears here. When both inputs of NOR gate are 0, 0, the output is 1. So, if the past output is 1 for the same inputs of S and R, the next state we have obtained is 1. 1. So, in order to, the meaning of this is, in order to store the value of 1 into the latch, we have to apply these combinations. S is 1, R is 0. If the past output is 0 or 1, a value 1 is stored. We call this as set, right? Set condition or set state. 1 is nothing but set, 0 is nothing but reset, because this is active high. Now let us see the last combination. When both inputs are 1, 1, I am applying S is 1, R is 1. Past output I am assuming as 0. The complement of this is 1. 0 appears here. 0, 1 will be, if you apply 0, 1 input to the NOR gate, the output is 0. Again this 0 appears here. 0, 1 are the inputs to the NOR gate. The output is 0. So here you got the output 0, and the complement of this is actually 1, but it is 0. So this condition is not valid, because true output is 0, complemented output is 0. If you assume the past output as 0, you got this condition, right? You got this, we call this as invalid, because true output is 0, complemented output is 0. We have one more combination for the same inputs S and R are 1. If you assume past output as 1, right, let us see what happens. See, the complement of this is 0, this 1 appears here. When both inputs of NOR gate are 1, 1, the output is 0, this is 0, this 0 appears here. 0, 1 are the inputs to the NOR gate. What is the output of the NOR gate? This is 0. If you apply this combination, what is the output you got? 0. Next state is 0, the complement of this is 0 you got. If you apply this combination, you got true output 0, complemented output 0, right? This is indeterminate, invalid condition. If true output is 0, the complemented output has to be 1, right? But the complemented output is also 0 here. For two combinations, you got the same output. True output and complemented output both are same. So this condition is not defined. So this state is called as invalid state. We call this as invalid state. Why we call this as invalid state? We got true and complemented outputs both are same for these two combinations. So this condition is defined as invalid condition or indeterminate state. This state is not determined in case of latch, right? Is this clear? So let us see once again. As we have explained, latch is an asynchronous sequential device. It stores a single bit of information, either a 0 or 1. It doesn't have a clock pulse. So at any instant of time, if you apply these input variables, depending on the past output, the output next state is changed, right? So if you want to store a value 0 into this latch, you have to apply this combination. If you apply this combination, a 0 value is stored in the latch. If you want to store a 1 value in the latch, this combination is applied, right? If you want to retain the past output as it is as next state, you have to apply this combination so that the value, either whatever it may be in the past output, either 0 or 1, it is retained as it is, right? Is this clear? This is nothing but latch. Latch is a storage element. It stores a single bit of information, either 0 or 1. In order to store a 0, you have to apply this combination. In order to store 1, you have to apply this combination. This SR NOR latch is designed using NOR gates. And the two inputs are applied at this terminal. The other two inputs of these two gates are taken from the outputs, true output and complemented outputs, as feedback to inputs of two NOR gates. Right? This feedback as a storage element. So this is the latch. Here we don't have a control signal, we don't have any clock pulse. At any instant of time, if these two inputs are changing, depending on the value of pass output, the next state will be changed, right? Let us see the waveforms of this. How to draw the waveforms? Waveforms of output, input and output waveforms. Input and output. This is the explanation in terms of a truth table. Let us see the explanation how we are representing the same truth table in terms of waveforms, signals. Just with respect to time, the input, you can take S first. This is S. This is level 0. This is level 1. Means active high 0 represents 0 volts, 1 represents 1 volt, right? Just there is no need to by heart this, just you can take any combination. These zeros and ones I am defining in terms of waveforms, that's it. This is 0 level, this is 1 level. This is logic 1, this is logic 0, right? And draw the dotted lines in order to draw the other input so that it will be easy for you. Here I will take R input. This is logic 1, this is logic 0, right? Your wish, you can take any input. I am taking this. Right? So this is 0, 1. If you want to designate, you can designate digits here. 0, 1, 0, 1, 0, 1. This is 0, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. Now draw the next state, Qn plus 1. Qn plus 1. Next state. This is level 0. Level 1. So let us assume initially you don't know what is stored in the latch. It has a previous value either 0 or 1. Initially you have to assume the past output either to 0 or 1. That is our wish. Right? So I am looking at the inputs. S is 0, R is 0. We don't know the past output initially. So we have to assume either 0 or 1. So look at this input combination 0, 0. Past output can be 0 or 1. So the previous output we don't know. So we have to assume the past output initially. That is your wish, you can assume either 0 or 1. I am assuming 0. If I assume 0, if the inputs are 0, 0, if the past output is assumed as 0, what is the next state you have? 0. 0. Right? Now this is the past output in order to represent the next state for these two inputs. Right? You have to assume the past output only for the initial case, either 0 or 1. In this initial case, I have assumed the past output as 0. Based on the past output, I have taken the next state as 0. Now look at the next combination. S is 1, R is 0. Past output is 0. S is 1, R is 0, past output is 0. What is the next state? 1. The next state is 1. Right? Now, look at the next combination. S is 0, R is 1, past output is this one for this inputs. The past output is this one. S is 0, R is 1, past output is 1. S is 0, R is 1. S is 0, R is 1, past output is 1. What is the next state? 0. Right? For this duration of time, the inputs are same. If these inputs are changing, the output will definitely change. Because there is no synchronization in this. At any instant of time, if the input is changing, the output will be affected. Now let us see for the combination 1 0. The past output is 0. 1 0. This is the past output 0. 1 0 0. What is the next state? 1. Next, for 1 0 combination. For 1 0 combination, you got this next state. Next, 0 1, past output is 1. 0 1, past output is 1. Reset. Next, 0 1 0, past output 0. 1 0, past output 0. Set. So this is 0 1 0 1 0 1. So starting from initial state, S is 0, R is 0, for this instant of time, we don't know the past output. Initially, we have to assume the past output. Based on the initial value of assumption, we have to draw the next state. So S is 0, R is 0, past output I have assumed as 0, so the next state is 1. And we got the past output for these input combinations, 1, 0, S is 1, R is 0, the past output is 0, S is 1, R is 0, the past output is 0, the next state is 1. Now this will be the past output for these input combinations, right? So by this way, you have to draw the waveforms. And this is the true output. It also has the complemented output. Q bar level 0 and 1. The complement of this will be this one. What is the complement of this? Just zeros will change to ones, ones will change. Here it is 0, here it will be 1. Here it is 1, it will be 0. 0, it will be 1. 1 will be 0. 0 will be 1. 1 will be 0. 1, 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. You got the complement of this. If you have 0, you will get 1. If you have 1, you will get 0. 0, 1. 1, 0. 0, 1.